Today's topic is fiber scans. Literally it means you scan, it's an ultrasound procedure actually. It's a, you scan the liver tissue to find out the fibrosis. Now I think this procedure is used in mammography also for fibroadenocarcinoma also. So what is a fiber scan? It's a rapid and user-friendly standalone device. It gives immediate results and a good reproducibility also. It's adequate for the diagnosis of severe fibrosis or cirrhosis compared with mild fibrosis, but its accuracy is very good for the diagnosis of secondary fibrosis. So ideal it's an ideal non-invasive test for diagnosis of liver fibrosis. It's very simple, reproducible, it's readily available nowadays, less expensive than biopsy, and predicts the full spectrum of fibrosis and reflects changes occurring with that. Particularly it's used for hepatitis C virus infection too. So this is a machine actually. Actually it costs more than a crore. It's available in MMC. It costs more than a crore. So this is how we do it. I'll come to that later actually. This is a procedure actually. Through the heterotopsis space you probe it. And this is the area of the interest. I'll come to that later. So the probe consists of an ultrasound transducer which is located at the end of the vibratory piston. The piston produces a vibration of low amplitude and frequency. It's actually the shear wave, it passes through the skin and liver tissue. Initially it passes shear wave, it's followed by the ultrasound wave and the reflection is measured. The ultrasound detects the propagation of the shear wave through the liver. At the depth, the point of interest is 2.5 to 6 cm below the skin surface and we measure the velocity. The shear wave velocity is directly related to the tissue stiffness, with a higher velocity equating to higher tissue stiffness, corresponding to increasing severity of fibrosis. So this is actually the procedure. The probe induces an elastic wave through the liver. The velocity of the wave is evaluated in the region of interest, normally between 2 to 6 centimeters. So the stiffness is affected by various conditions like acute inflammation, various fibrosis, portal fibrosis, sinusoidal fibrosis, central liver fibrosis, etc., as well as presence of fatty liver. So the main operating principle is VCTA, so-called the Vibration Controlled Transient Elastography. So this procedure is always called as, older books mentioned as a transient elastography, either fibroscan or a transient elastography. So the steps as I have mentioned earlier, first you mechanically induce the shear wave, the measure the shear wave and calculate the stiffness by a formula. So this is first you this is a probe actually, which is through the intercostal space, the liver is approached. And this is the actual shear wave, which is induced first. So this is the basic difference between a routine ultrasound and this one. So first you induce a shear wave, which passes through the liver. This is followed by a ultrasonic wave, which reflection is measured. So basically, when the speed is low, the stiffness is low. When the speed is very high, the stiffness is also higher. So this is how you measure the shear wave. So this is actually the picture you get it on the monitor. So first you pass through the region of interest from the start from 2.5 mm, you go down up to 6 centimeters you go. And this area you calculate. Okay. This is a distance passed and with the time you calculate by the formula. Basically elasticity is equal to lift thrice the liver tissue and the shear wave velocity works. It is everything, the computer does it and you get the reading. Okay, so when the speed is low, it's normal. When the speed is very fast, there is fibrosis. We are basically measuring the fibrosis only. Whereas when there is established cirrhosis or when there is a fatty liver, ultrasound is a test. It is for in between. So we have four stages, F0, F1, F2, F3, F4. F0 is normal, no fibrosis. F1, mild fibrosis. And F2 have some fibrosis which can involve the nearby vascular tissues also. F3 fibrosis to fibrosis, something like a bridging cirrhosis, bridges. And F4 is established cirrhosis. So whatever primary fibroscan applications is used to assess the urgency of need of care, particularly in hepatitis C patients. Because earlier we were using interferons for treating hepatitis C, but now only oral therapies directly acting antivirals only they are using. So for treating and prognostication purpose, it's very useful. And mainly for alcoholic patients, we can predict when they go for cirrhosis. So mainly for the hepatitis C virus infection as well as for patients with alcoholic liver disease. So basically this is the values actually when it is more than 9. The values you get is in kilopascals.
Okay.
So when it's around 9, it's like a grade 3, fibrosis 3 stage. And when it's around 12, it's fibrosis F4 stage. And it's a very well validated study. It has approved by the FDA in 2014 actually. So the various factors again can influence the liver's difference actually. Patients with alcohol, increased hepatic pressure, and hepatic inflammation, they lead to fibrosis and the liver stiffness increases. So we don't have basically we are avoiding liver biopsy. By using this test, we are avoiding liver biopsy. So only restriction the patient should come on fasting 3 hours before the procedure. And drinking water is actually allowed. The limitations are obesity, very morbid obesity as I discussed previously. Morbid obesity patients, we cannot do it properly. And some patients with narrowed intercostal spaces, again, quite difficult to get it. And patients with acute hepatitis, it's a contraindication. Sometimes because of the ballooning, we cannot measure it properly. And again, ascites is a contraindication. So in summary, basically, we perform a liver stiffness, that's fibrosis. We perform the liver stiffness measurement. If it's less than 6 kPa, there is no significant fibrosis. And that is, it's F0 or F1, no need for any biopsy at all. When the values are intermediate or it's in the gray area, it's F2 or F3. This is where we use fibrosis scan nowadays, okay, instead of biopsy. And when it's greater than 12 kPa, it's advanced fibrosis, F3 or F2, no need for biopsy at all. Now we have some modifications also, so-called ARFI, acoustic radiation force impulse actually. That's also using an ultrasound, some people use that also. It's a bit cost effective. Thank you. Yeah, in the MMC they have it, sir. We bought it for more than 1 crore. And another KMC and SMC, we have tie up with some companies. And we, every Wednesday we do it free of cost. Even in my another bed floor, we are doing free of cost. Every Wednesday we do it.
Thank you. I request Dr. Somasundaram, please come forward and hand over the certificate of appreciation. Conducted a blood donation camp on June 3rd of this month. I request our President Dr. Eddie Larson to come forward and honor